Hey folks, welcome back to Jerome Bee Farm and Homestead. It is Friday, May 6th, and it's a beautiful day here in central Oklahoma. It's about 72 degrees, just a slight south breeze. Very calm, very strange for Oklahoma. It's usually blowing like crazy. But so we had, all April was crazy windy, and the first week of May, I think we averaged probably an inch of rain a day. I think yesterday, I think it said I had 5.5 inches on the month of April. So we've had a lot of rain. The pond is full. The pond went over the spillway, which that's just a little plastic thing. So yeah, it overflowed. And my work on the pond last year, where I built up part of the dam where it wouldn't go over the back, so that worked. And didn't have any washouts on it this time. So that was a good thing. So today, it's been a week since I've been in here, and my last video, I did that split on number 15, found the queen, moved her out, and pulled two splits off of that one, I think. 12 and Hive 99, formerly known as 13, and so we got those there. And also, I went through the rest of my hives that I had not inspected, the ones that had two honey supers, checked those. And strangely enough, they had some cups, but there was no larva in any of them. So I guess they're just in a honey making mode. And that's good, because I don't want to have to break them down. And one of them actually had both supers, 2/3 full. So I went ahead and put a third on it. That's number seven there, just over the trailer. So, man, we have a good flow going on. We've got some good forage days. Just coming off that week of lots of rain, a lot of severe weather, had tornadoes to the south and east of us. So hope everyone's okay out that way. So after I did some other inspections, I did find some more queen cells, and I did pull some splits. I think I wound up with 7 or 8 on the day, and I had several nukes. Some of them I just put in the single deep, but I've got 3 nukes down on the end. And while I was doing that, I had a frame that was natural comb and had some queen cells higher up on the frame. So I actually cut those out with my knife and took them up to the house, put them in a little container there in my office. And actually had a queen emerge on Tuesday. So this video, I'm going to take that queen, I'm going to pull a split from one of these, and I'm just going to do I think 3 frames in a nuke and try and bank this virgin queen, get her mated, and use her for something else later on. And or I might sell a nuke, who knows. Who knows how all these splits are going to turn out. So those queens, they've got to emerge and go out and mate and come back and start laying. So we got to wait on that to happen. So another video I will do is we'll go in and we'll check those nukes. So it's been a week, so we can see if the queens are emerged and what they look like. It's still a little early for them to be laying, but let me get this queen out of here. So I got her in here. I was keeping her out of the sun. But I don't know if you can see her there. Where is she? Oh, she's right here, kind of in that little corner. Anyway, so I've given her some water and some honey, and I'm concerned she's been in there by herself. So I went ahead and I opened the cell right next to her because I thought they would be the same age. They weren't. That one next to her wasn't developed hardly at all. And there's a third cell in here right there, and I haven't touched it. So I don't know if that'll emerge or not. I'm just going to leave it in there. But let's find us a hive and get some brood and some pollen and a little bit of honey and make us probably a 3-frame split and whatever we find, and we'll get her put in there. So let's get going. Okay, we'll start right here with these two hives. This is number 3 and 4. So I'm gonna get the super off, and I'm gonna start with 3, get the super off of there, and see what we can find. So these two hives here are, I classed them as medium strong, and they both had empty queen cups on April 20th. So it's May 6th. So they may be full of queen cups now. For my notes, these two hives I didn't check. I checked the ones with double supers last week. Not much weight to this super. So they're not doing much with it. Got a decent amount of bees up here. So you can see I got my nuke box set up ready there. I got three empty frames undrawn right there. So this hive still doesn't look real strong. If I remember right, I brought up a brood frame to get them going in the top because they weren't doing much up top. They had it all in the bottom. There's a honey frame with some capped honey left from last year. I'm just going to go ahead and get over on into the business here where the bees are at. Hopefully we can find us a nice brood frame up here. That's just a little bit of nectar in that, not much going on. This hive been real strong. I don't want to pick on my really nice hives that are going to be making a lot of honey to make these splits. Plus they're full of queen cells already. So here's pollen and nectar. So this next one ought to be a brood frame. I can see a few brood on there already. Yeah, this is what we want. So there's some uncapped and capped. I really wish I had one that was mostly capped. Making sure our queen's not on here. So this frame here is pretty self-sufficient. You got your brood in here. You got a band of pollen. And in the corners, you've got nectar. So I'm just going to go ahead and set this in our nuke. Bees and all. I don't see my queen. I think in this frame here is going to be much of the same thing. And it is. So this time of year, you don't have to worry so much about your brood getting chilled. Don't see my queen. There's some little queen cups down here on the bottom, but they're not doing anything with them. Oh, there's my queen right here. I'm going to capture her. She's not marked. So we've got her right here. Now I'm going to shake bees from frames on both sides here. We need one more frame though. Let me see what this one looks like. This is a nectar and pollen frame. So this hive here has everything it needs now except a queen and enough bees to maintain it. So I'm going to find me a brood frame from down below and shake in some nurse bees. Put our queen over here where she's safe. I may just go ahead and take two more frames out of here. So I've got five in that nuke. I was going to try and do it all with that top box, but I am going to have to go get a couple of more frames. So no need messing around here. What we want is the brood, and that's going to be right in here. I may grab another honey frame for that other side, and then a blank. There's a nice blank frame to put in there with them. So I want a brood frame that's got capped brood on it, or any brood actually. And I'm going to shake off the nurse bees into my nuke box. So here's a good candidate. So most of the bees on this frame are nurse bees. They're going to stay put. The ones that aren't nurse bees will fly back over there to their home. So this is going to boost that population up where we need it in our nuke. So here's a good frame that's got a lot of uncapped and a few capped, same on this side. So we'll go ahead and checkerboard in some blanks between these two brood frames. These are waxed. I've waxed the foundation, added wax to it, so they'll take to it a lot better. Had some old natural colored. I tried to run black. Somehow I wound up with some natural colored accidentally. Okay, that takes care of the bottom. So I'm gonna drop our queen off. There's a brood frame right here. We're gonna drop her right there. So I really should mark her, but I left my container that had my markers up at the house. She's going the wrong way. Now all the bees are in her way. There we go. Let go. Go down. There she is right there, going in. Okay, now we can put this empty frame here. That'll give us four. So I'm just gonna stick with that for now. We can add a frame later. Make sure our queen's not up around that edge. I don't see her. So this is honey. We're gonna put it on the outside. So I'm gonna run up to the house and get a couple more frames. I'm gonna put this blank one inside this nuke. Okay, I ran up and got a couple of nice drawn comb frames here. They are dated 2019. I'm gonna put this nice, even, pretty one right here in the middle. And this one here needs cleaned up a little bit. Actually, a little bit of pollen in that one. Cleaning up propolis here, make them fit a little better. Okay, this hive really, it could be reduced, but we're right in the heat of the nectar flow, so I'm just gonna go with it for now. Probably not gonna get honey out of this hive, but at least they will fill. Hopefully they fill this top box here and they'll be set for winter. Especially since I took two nice, well, decent brood frames from them. That queen's not gonna win any awards, that's for sure. Okay, we made it this far. So hopefully we don't botch this part up. Let me get the camera zoomed in here. You can see what I'm doing. Queen's on this little queen cell. I'm just gonna lay it right here. Well, she fell. She just walked down. You could probably see it on the camera. She went down right there. So I'm debating whether to put this in there with her, but I'm gonna keep it in here. See if it'll go ahead and emerge. So now we'll take this over and put it on the nuke stand. We got stuff sticking up here. So these nuke lids, they fit real close. See this bark comb right here? That's what's keeping that from going down. You want a nice flush fit with your nuke lids, because it's a fairly weak colony and ants will run your bees out of there. There we go. So we'll go get this thing set up. Okay, we got our nuke box where we want it. I'm gonna reduce the entrance down with the patented Jerome Bee Farm entrance reducer here. Link below, you can get these from my store. I'll give you all the friends and family discount. So this, we want to batten this thing down, close it up tight where they have a little entrance. So that's like 3/4 of an inch, 1/2 inch right there, which is perfect for this small little hive. They don't need the volume going in and out. They got everything they need in here to survive. They got nectar, they've got pollen, they've got brood, and now they have a queen. So the queen needs to go out, she needs to mate, and make it back successfully. And we'll leave these little blocks here for her calling card. She'll know this is her hive. I don't know if that works. People do that, I do that. I think it may be more of a human thing than a bee thing. So anyway, we're gonna leave those on there, and hopefully she'll get out and mate, and she's not too upset. She spent the first 3 days of her life in a solitary confinement in my office. So, but I was there to keep her company every now and then. So anyway, that is it. We'll check back on this in a couple weeks, and hopefully we'll have a laying queen in here. I hope you enjoyed it. Give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe on your way out. And we'll catch you on the next beekeeping video. Y'all take care.